Good morning. Today we're going to demonstrate the components of projectile motion by building velocity and acceleration vector diagrams.
Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Let's start with a quick review of projectile motion. Bobby, please remind me, what is true of the motion of a projectile in the X direction?
In the X direction, a projectile will move at a constant velocity.
Correct. In the X direction, the velocity of a projectile is constant. Billy, what about the motion of a projectile in the Y direction?
In the Y direction, a projectile experiences uniformly accelerated motion with an acceleration equal to the negative of the acceleration due to gravity. On Earth, that acceleration would be equal to negative 9.81 meters per second squared.
Yes, in the y direction, the acceleration is constant. Therefore, we can use the UAM equations of motion. Therefore, projectile motion is made up of a horizontal and a vertical component. The horizontal component is constant velocity. And the vertical component is uniformly accelerated motion, with a downward acceleration that has a magnitude of 9.81 meters per second squared. Now, let's combine them all. Again, notice how the x direction has a constant velocity and the y direction has a uniform downward acceleration. Now let's add velocity vector components in the x direction. Bobby, what should the velocity vector components look like in the x direction for the ball as it moves to the right?
Well, in the x direction, the ball has a constant velocity to the right, so the vector should have the same magnitude the whole time and be pointed to the right.
Correct. So as the ball moves to the right, we can freeze the ball at several locations and add the velocity vector in the x direction, which will always have the same magnitude and therefore the same length arrow. Now, let's look at just the upward motion of the ball in the y direction. Billy, what should that velocity vector look like?
Well, we know the ball must start with an upward velocity in the y direction, and because the acceleration is downward, that velocity will decrease as the ball goes upward. So the magnitude of the velocity vector will decrease, and it should eventually reach zero at the very top.
Correct. And Bo, what about the velocity vectors of the ball in the y direction as the ball is going downward?
As Billy pointed out, at the very top in the y direction, the ball has a velocity of zero. So the ball will have an initial velocity of zero and accelerate downward. So the velocity will have an increasing downward magnitude as the ball goes down.
So again, in the y direction as the ball moves upward, that velocity will be upward and decrease in magnitude until it reaches zero at the very top. As the ball moves down, that velocity will start out at zero and increase in magnitude and always be downward. Now, let's take a look at projectile motion. Remember, projectile motion is a combination of the horizontal and the vertical components. So we can now take those horizontal and vertical velocity vectors and add them to the projectile motion video. Those velocity vectors are the x and y components of the resultant projectile motion velocity vectors, which we can now add to the video. And there are all the velocity vectors for projectile motion.
Wow, that's pretty cool, Mr. P.
Hold up, Mr. P.
I don't get what you just did with the velocity vectors in projectile motion.
Yeah, can you please explain how you got those resultant velocities?
Oh, okay, sure. Let's take a look at the initial velocity vectors. The components of the initial velocity look like this, and we can do tip-to-tail vector addition to determine the resultant initial velocity vector. And you can see we get the initial velocity vector right here. And because of the associative property of vector addition, we can actually add them in any order. So let's do it again, only this time starting with the initial velocity in the y direction. And we get the same resultant initial velocity vector. And we can illustrate that on our original diagram like this. And you can see we get a rectangle, a diagonal of which is the resultant velocity vector. Does that help?
Yes, thanks.
I get it now.
Good. Now, I do want to add acceleration to the picture as well. So, on the projectile motion video, let's remove all the velocity vector components and just leave the resultant velocity. Now, what about acceleration? Bobby, what do you know about the acceleration of the projectile in the y direction?
The acceleration is constant at 9.81 meters per second squared downward the whole time.
The whole time? Even when the ball is going upward?
Yes, even when a projectile is moving upward, its acceleration is still downward and constant.
Very good, Bobby. So now we can add a constant downward acceleration to both the upward and downward moving projectiles. Now, Billy, what about the acceleration of the ball in the x direction?
Because the ball moves at a constant velocity in the x direction, the acceleration in the x direction is zero.
Yes, and we illustrate that in the diagram by, well, not adding anything, which means that the net acceleration is just the acceleration in the y direction, which we can now add to the projectile motion video. And that is a visual description of the velocity and acceleration components of an object in projectile motion. There you have it. We just demonstrated the horizontal and vertical components of projectile motion by building velocity and acceleration vector diagrams. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.